Hello students, in last topic we have discussed about the development of lateral surface of the simple solids. Now here we will discuss about the development of lateral surface of the truncated solids or the solids which are cut by the cutting plane. So this is problem which we have considered here for the development, and as per the problem, the hexagonal prism of a base 25 mm is given, whose axis is 65 mm long, and it is resting on HP and one of its edge is perpendicular to the BP. Okay, and the condition for the cutting plane is given. It is cut by the cutting plane which is perpendicular to the VP and inclined at a 55 degree to the HP, and it is bisecting the axis. Okay, and then we have to draw the development of lateral surface after cutting. Okay, so this will be considered as a truncated solid because it is cut by the cutting plane. So hexagonal prism is given, so and the edge of that hexagonal prism is 25 mm and the axis is a 65 mm. So we have to draw its front view and the top view. So we know that the top view shows the hexagonal base and the top face is overlapping on the bottom face. Okay, and the front view shows a rectangle. So first we will start with the top view because the true shape of that prism is visible in a top view. So we will start with the XY line first. So first we have to draw XY line, which is a reference line between the vertical plane and the horizontal plane. So above XY line there is a vertical plane and below horizontal plane. Okay, so this vertical plane shows the front view, whereas this horizontal plane shows the top view. Okay, so to draw this hexagonal prism, first we have to draw a circle of a radius equal to the base edge. The base edge is equal to 25 mm, so we have to take a radius equal to 25 mm, and then we have to draw a circle with the same radius. Okay, so it should be a thin, because it is only a construction, we are using it only to inscribe that hexagon within it. So after that we have to find out the position of the base edges in a top view. So one condition is given here, one of the edge of the base is perpendicular to the VP. Okay, so this means it should be a vertical, that edge must be a vertical. So to make that vertical lines in a prism or the top face of the prism or the in a top view of a prism, we have to draw a vertical diagonal here. Okay, so this will be a vertical diagonal which is perpendicular to the XY line. So these are nothing but a two corners of that hexagon. Now we have to locate another four corners, because we know that the hexagonal prism or the hexagonal plane will be having a six different corners. So take a distance equal to 25 mm, which is equal to the base edge, and then from these points you can locate the another or remaining four points. Okay, so these are the four corners of that hexagon. Now we have to join all these points on the circle with each other with a line which is nothing but a top view of that hexagonal prism. And the condition which is given in the problem is satisfied here. These two lines are perpendicular to the XY or the vertical plane. See, as per the statement given in the problem, these two lines, base edges, are perpendicular to the XY line or the vertical plane. Okay, so the condition is satisfied. So to draw these perpendicular edges to the VP, we have to take a vertical diagonal here. Okay, now we have to find out the location of the axis. Now we have to join the opposite corners with the line. So these diagonals will intersect each other at the center, which represent the position of the axis. Okay, so point of intersection is here. So this will be O comma S, which is representing the two points of the axis. O is at the top and S at the bottom. Now we have to name the top surface and the bottom surface here. So this will be A comma 1, this will be B comma 2, C comma 3, D comma 4, then E comma 5 and F comma 6. So these alphabets are indicating the bottom face and the numbers are indicating the top face. Now we'll draw a front view of that prism. So to draw front view, we have to transfer these points to the front view. Okay. Now to locate the height of the rectangle, which is nothing but a front view, we have given with the axis height, which is 65 mm. So the axis height is 65 mm, and these longer edges of the prism are parallel to the central axis, then so that we can take the same distance on this line. Then we have to join this line. So this will complete the front view. Okay. So another thing is, if you observe this hexagonal prism from this side for the front view, so this arrow shows the position of the observer for the front view. So this edge, longer edge E5, which joins the bottom E with the top 5 point, is also visible in front view. So this edge is also visible. Okay. So first we have to construct this front view with a continuous thin line, because we have to locate the position of the cutting plane here. Okay. Now we have to name the bottom face and the top face of this front view. So this F will overlap on A. So this point will be A dash and F dash. So E will overlap on B. So this will be B dash, E dash. D will overlap on C. So this is C dash and D dash. So after that, the top face 1 will overlap on 6. So this will be 1 dash, 6 dash. 2 will overlap on 5. So this will be 2 dash, 5 dash. And 3 or 4 will overlap on 3. So this will be 3 dash and the 4 dash. Lastly, we have to locate the position of the axis. So this will be O dash and this bottom point will be S dash. Now we have to locate the position of the cutting plane here. So for locating the position of the cutting plane, the position of the cutting plane is given in the problem. That cutting plane is perpendicular to the VP and it is having an inclination with the HP of a 55 degree. And another condition is that axis or the line which indicate the cutting plane is bisecting the axis of the prism. Okay, that is the OS. So to locate the position of that cutting plane, we have to take a midpoint of this OS line, which is nothing but a axis of the prism. Okay, so this will be equal to 32.5. So we have to locate this point here, which is a midpoint of OS line. Then we have to draw a one horizontal line up to this longer edge, which is parallel to the XY line. Okay, now after that, we have to take a 55 degree angle with the help of this protractor. So this will be a 55 degree angle. Okay, now we have to draw a center line or the cutting plane line, which shows the position of the cutting plane in this figure. Okay, so this cutting plane line is nothing but a center line which is having thick ends. Okay, so we have to show this cutting plane line with the help of a center line, but the difference is it is having a thick ends, and these thick ends are located at outside of the object. Okay, so this will be the cutting plane. Now we have to make the visible portion of the prism dark. So this upper portion we have to remove. Only the remaining portion is the bottommost portion, which is taped on the HP. So we have to draw the development of this surface only. So we have neglected this top surface for the development. Okay, so only this much of the portion is visible, because the upper portion is cut by the cutting plane. So we have to make only this much of the portion dark. We have to use continuous thick line. Okay, so we have to go for the development of lateral surface of this hexagonal prism now, because we have completed the front view and the top view of that object. So for development we have to extend this XY line. Okay, and we have to extend this top surface of that prism as well. Okay, then we have to take one of the line which is parallel to the longer edge of that prism, and its length will be equal to the height of the axis. Okay, and we know that the development of lateral surface of the hexagonal prism will shows 6 different rectangles of a size equal to the base edge and the axis height of that prism. Okay, so we have to locate that 6 different rectangle here, and the total development of a lateral surface of that hexagonal prism will be equal to the perimeter of that hexagon. Okay, so what is the length of that rectangle is nothing but a perimeter of that hexagon. So this hexagon is having 6 sides, so perimeter is equal to number of the sides into its length. So number of the sides are 6 into its length is a 25. So total perimeter will be of a 150 mm. Okay, so this length of the rectangle will be equal to 150 mm. So we have to take this 150 mm here and at the top face as well, 150. Then we have to join these two points with a vertical line, which is another side of that particular rectangle. So we have to construct this development with the help of the construction line only, because we have to inscribe the visible portion of this development within this rectangle. Okay, so after that we have to locate 6 different rectangles. So the base edge length is given, which is 25 mm. Now we have to locate 6 base edges. So 2nd, 3rd, 4th, this is the 5th, and last one is the 6th. So we have to locate the same point at the top face as well, or you can draw a parallel line to this longer edge. 5, 75, then 100, 125, and 150. So these are the 6 different edges at the bottom and the top face. Now we have to join these points with the vertical line, which are nothing but a longer edges of that particular hexagonal prism. So this is a complete development of lateral surface of the prism. Okay, so we have to name these points. So we'll start from the A. So this is A, then B, C, D, E, F, and lastly again this will be A, because we have cut this square prism at 1A. So this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this will be again 1. Okay, so this is a complete development of lateral surface of this complete prism. Okay, but we have shown the cutting plane here, and it is cut by this cutting plane, and the upper portion we have removed. So only we have to show the development of this bottom section of that particular prism. So to locate this bottom portion of this prism in the development, we have to find out this point of intersection of this cutting plane with the corresponding longer edges of that prism. So we'll start from here. Okay, so this cutting plane is cutting this longer edge 1A at this location. Okay, and we have to find the same longer edges in the development here. So we are having a 2 1A edges here, here and at the last. So we have to transfer the same distance to that longer edges parallel to the XY line. So this will be your first point P1. Okay, now move to the B, which is representing B2 generator or the longer edge. So this is a B2 generator or the longer edge, and this cutting plane is cutting this longer edge here at the center. So we have to find the same longer edge here in a development. So this is a B2 longer edge. So we have to transfer that point here parallel to the XY. So this point of intersection will be P2. Okay, we have transferred this point of intersection of this cutting plane with the generator B2. Now we will go for the C3 generator. So position of the C3 generator is here. Okay, so this cutting plane is cutting that generator here at the top face, that is at the top corner. Okay, so we'll locate the point here on a 3. So this will be point P3. Similarly, if we go for the D4 generator, okay, so this cutting plane is cutting at the same distance here. So this point will be a 4. So this is a P4. Okay, so after that we have to move for E5 generator or the longer edge. So the position of the E5 is here. Okay, this 2B will overlap on BE. Sorry, 2B is overlapping on this E5. Okay, so the distance will be equal. So we'll transfer the same point on the E5 longer edge or the generator. So this point will be a P5. Okay, E5. This cutting plane is cutting E5 generator here. So we have transferred that distance to the E5 generator or the longer edge in a development. Clear? So after that, last point is F6, and the cutting plane is cutting that F6 generator or the longer edge here. So we can extend that point. Here, so this will be the point of intersection. So this will be point P6. Okay, and at the same location we are having this A1 longer edge cut by the cutting plane. So this will be your last point, that is P1 again. So these are the points we have located. Now this upper portion we have to remove, and the bottom portion within these longer edges we have to show with the dark line, which is nothing but a development of lateral surface of the prism which is cut by the cutting plane. Okay, first we have to show the base, which is completely visible. Now we'll start from the 1A. So we have to join this A point P with the P1, then we have to join this P1 with the P2, then P2 with the P3, then P3 with the P4, which is a horizontal line. Okay, then P4 with the P5, P5 with the P6, lastly P6 to the P1, again back to A, P1 to A. Okay, after that we have to show the longer edges. So this is a B2 up to this end only, we have to show it with the dark line. So this is a complete development of lateral surface of the hexagonal prism which is cut by the cutting plane, and this cutting plane is inclined at 55 degree with the HP, and it is perpendicular to the VP. And the another condition is it is bisecting this axis, okay, of the prism, and the angle is 55 degree. Okay, so lastly we have to show the dimension for this development. So the complete length of the development is equal to the perimeter of the hexagon. So the perimeter is 150. Height of the axis of the prism is 65 mm. So we have to show it. 65 mm, and after that we have to show the edge length, which is given in a problem. So this will complete the development of lateral surface of the hexagonal prism, which is cut by the cutting plane.